They're organizing for a reason.
You can only see them face to face. No mirrors, no photos, no videos.
Mike, what happened to Jack? He's dead, isn't he?
They know about her, they know about you, and they want to know about us.
No one can make you do anything you don't want to do.
My five-year-old daughter didn't choose to go. They don't just recruit, they kill.
What they're researching is pollution, contamination of their food supply.
These people that you're with, and you think we're evil.
Time to move. It's only Clapham, just down the road.
Plenty of room. Get a football team in there.
What have you got for us, eh? Marion? Eh? Hey. Hello?
Careful, you'll bust your eardrums. And what's a nice girl like you doing with a vicious bit of kit like that? Living hope. Eh?
Sorry to bother you. I'm looking for Michael Colefield.
ما بفهم شو عم تحكي.
He used to live here recently.
لا والله ما بعرف شيء.
Is there anyone else in the house that speaks English?
لا ما في حدا بحكي انجليزي.
How'd you find me? Sorry, I was gonna call.
Eventually. I know. I thought I'd impress you. You covered your tracks very well. Unless the lady might have given up. Here. Take it there's not gonna be a flat warming?
No.
Kirsty? You're being sensible. And tough. You just put it in a corner and forget about it. Doesn't need watering, it's very low maintenance. Remind you of anyone?
Maybe.
We haven't got the attack itself, but we've taken views from half a dozen different spots. None of them show the assailant leaving or entering the area.
How do you know it wasn't her?
You been to the morgue?
Doesn't take much to break a neck if you know where to push. Maybe she did self-defense. Anyhow, I'll have all these videos.
Thought you were here to assist.
You'll have them sent over. Thank you.
I get night terrors occasionally.
You've had it worse, typical doctor. I'm not talking about nightmares, just night sweats. This is not psychological.
Are you sure? Any stress at work?
It's just a desk job.
Well, is there anything else I should know apart from general fatigue?
I've lost weight.
I know. Looks good on you. Thought you'd been working out.
My spare time. No, not much appetite lately. Strange taste in my mouth.
Nausea, vomiting? Why don't you come down this afternoon? We'll run some tests.
I would like this to be between us.
Okay, we'll run them here then.
Marion Wainwright, barrister. These are her cases over the last 2 years. She's got three on at the minute. Here's one we might want to take a look at. Fraud case. It's been going for over a year and it's an absolute bitch to unravel. Something to do with VAT on imports.
VAT?
Big money. Leeches like money.
And she's so crucial to the defence, they couldn't risk losing her.
I can't see anything else to tie her in.
Family?
Husband topped himself 2 years ago. Everyone else close is accounted for. She's got nothing they want. Her number two's in court this morning, so we're going to be serious fraud.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm Jacob. You spoke to my editor. I won't introduce you. He'll be on my back if we do it here.
Sure. Well, before he changed his story, Michael said that Jack was on the run. People were trying to kill him. Either the police or people above the police.
And do you think Michael's joined in?
Maybe not willingly. I'd like to think not willingly. If they did do something to Jack, maybe he's got good reason to go into hiding.
All he had to do was stick around and lie to you about it.
He has been.
Yeah, but why run off on that guilty? You've got no proof. Why would he do that?
He knew I'd get it out of him.
He likes you. Yeah, I mean, do you like him?
We were friends.
Someone kills your fiancé. He helps cover it up, then moves house without telling you. No forwarding address. I mean, call me old-fashioned, but that doesn't sound very friendly to me.
Look, you're the journalist. If you find him, you can ask
him. Yeah, that's right. I'm a journalist. I'm not a missing persons bureau. I'm interested, okay?
We're not suggesting anything.
Then why do I feel like it's me you're investigating?
It's the crime we're investigating.
Well, as I was unconscious for the duration of that crime, there's very little I can tell you. Why are you assuming I'm the reason this happened? Those two thugs are more likely to have violent associates than I am.
Who picked that exact moment to step in, with you as a witness? You know what he did to your assailants?
Yes. It doesn't look like he was operating very rationally, does it?
You've got me there. Sorry. This case predates me. I was still in school when it started. I still haven't worked out Mr. Keep's filing system. I think he did it deliberately so no one could take over.
Sorry, who's Mr. Keep?
Dominic Keep, my illustrious predecessor. He had an accident.
What kind of accident?
A fatal kind. Hit and run.
Did they get the driver?
Do they ever?
Your husband was a court artist.
It's how we met. I complained how terrible the likeness was. He never did crack it, really.
Sorry.
It's all right. It wasn't yesterday.
I lost my husband too, you know. Similar circumstances.
He killed himself. Yes. Do you know why?
Not completely.
I suppose I couldn't give him what he wanted. I know how that feels. She passed out when they attacked her. Has that happened before?
I don't care what authority you've got. I am not releasing these details without patient consent.
I've already got her details. You were treating her for depression, correct? Because of her husband's suicide?
If you've got access to her notes, somehow, you can make do with those. I am not divulging private conversations.
I'm a doctor. I understand your concerns, and I'm sensitive to the issues. But if you don't cooperate, I'll have you struck off. It'll take one phone call.
Dominic Keep, age 32, bog standard hit and run.
No idea of the type of vehicle.
It was a wet night. No tire marks, no witnesses.
Nothing on the body? No paint, no glass?
Clean hit.
So you don't think it was deliberate?
We spoke to his law firm. Ran a few checks on people he'd helped put away. No, I don't.
What about his personal life? Was he seeing anyone?
He was friendly with Marion Wainwright. But before you get excited, her husband's 6 foot under.
Where?
They've been trying for 8 or 9 years. She'd been pregnant 12 times. All miscarried. The last one was at 5 months.
Strange it should drive the husband to suicide.
Well, they're a strange couple.
And it was suicide?
Oh, yes. There was no issue about that. The wounds were self-inflicted.
So the body was found drained. Why do you think he did it?
Children had become an obsession. They couldn't see past it. Her, especially. I don't think he could take any more. She was never going to give up. She'd still be at it at my age.
He could have left her.
No. I don't think he could.
Am I under arrest? If so, what for?
You knew a Dominic Keep?
I worked with him. He was a friend.
Did you have a relationship?
No.
After your husband died?
No. Never.
Was it on the cards, though, before this hit and run?
I liked Dominic. He was a great support after Anthony died. He kept me going. I didn't want a relationship. He knew that.
Perhaps he hoped you'd change your mind. Was that so impossible?
I'm not answering any more of these questions.
Where were you when he died?
Do I have to account for all my movements now? I'm sorry, I won't. Not unless you start producing some specifics on what you're looking for. I'd like to know who you report to. And I'd like to know where my lawyer is. And I'd like to know why you're not taping this interview.
Yeah. Well, I'm drawing a blank here at Marion's place.
How about you?
Yeah, well, I'll let you know if Wainwright's in.
Your head of chambers tells me you've been taking time off work recently. Have you been ill? Can I get you something?
Thank you.
Men are gone. I thought her GP said she wasn't on anything.
Is there a nasal spray?
Yeah. Well, the label says...
Cinerel.
That's the one.
It's a gestational sac.
There's nothing inside. How far?
About 10 weeks. You haven't been to any tropical countries in the last few years.
No. Could there be any natural explanation for this?
There is a condition. An embryonic gestation. Lighted ovum.
Yes, I've heard of it. The embryo dies.
The sac keeps growing, but there's no structure inside. I've done an abdominal scan, but I need to do a vaginal high res, but even then, you haven't had any loss of breath.
No. What about fetal heartbeat?
I can't detect any.
Best guess?
Not till I've spoken to the mother.
For all dominant, well, I suppose it's not unreasonable to think he was in with a shout with Mr. Wainwright dead 18 months. Gave it a decent weight before he moved in. He must have had his eye on her. Well, she's pretty good looking. Same line of business, good at her job. I suppose that's a turn on as well. And she's a widow, far as he knew. Suppose it wasn't his fault he didn't know she was into necrophilia.
Or whether she is or not, it's not his.
Why?
Sex is something the leeches use to get what they want. It's not how they make other leeches, is it? The females don't menstruate. It's a waste of good blood. And as far as your male leech is concerned, he can get it up all right, but they're sterile.
Then how is she pregnant?
I'm sorry.
Are you sure? I have been sick.
Hormonal upheaval, I know. It's all normal with phantom pregnancy. Now, who's the father?
My husband.
Your late husband.
I wasn't broadcasting it because I didn't want to talk about it till it was safe. Miscarriages are hard enough without people's sympathy.
Your husband's sperm were frozen before he died.
It's all above board. I've got the consent forms. I just don't like shouting about it.
Was there anything wrong before he died?
He was perfectly fine, apart from, you know, poor sperm motility. It's where we had IVF in the first place. It was his idea to get some frozen. In case anything ever happened.
Intracytoplasmic sperm injection, ICSI. Relatively cutting edge. It involves manipulating a single sperm into an egg and then re-implanting. The drugs you found control ovulation so the maximum number of eggs can be harvested at one sitting.
So what is it, some kind of crossbreed?
I can't say until we trace through all the stages. It may be a normal phantom pregnancy. I'm meeting a consultant who performed the in vitro. I'd like you to check out the storage facility.
What if it's not a phantom? What if she stays pregnant?
We'll cross that bridge when we come to it.
Where would you like to start?
How many embryos did you produce for Mrs. Wainwright?
Just the one.
That's unusual. Don't you implant two or three?
Only one fertilized. His sperm was very poor quality.
Zero motility.
Was it like that before it was frozen? Before he died?
Actually, no, not quite. We treated him with pentoxifilin.
Did you have any difficulty with the injection procedure?
What do you mean?
You saw the sperm on video.
Bit difficult otherwise.
Mr. Wainwright, I presume.
You don't approve, do you? But don't worry, you're not alone. When I'm at dinner parties, I'm a lab technician now. I learned the hard way.
I don't have a problem.
Doctors are the worst. I suppose you think everyone should be working on cancer. Enough babies as it is, right?
I don't think that.
What is your speciality then?
Cancer.
Are they still frozen?
No.
So they're dead? If this were Code 5 tissue, we wouldn't be able to see it on video.
That is correct. However, the sperm envelope is human, but the genetic information is code 5. What they're after is compatibility with the human ovum. Once it's penetrated and fertilization has occurred, who knows which characteristics win out? I doubt if they know.
If the experiment is successful, the pregnancy develops. It's not immortal.
It might have immunity to daylight.
Yes, but it would age and die. It doesn't add up.
No. Not if it is just an experiment.
You're not, I hope, suggesting they have any desire or need for offspring, are you?
IVF doesn't let anyone off the hook, however old you are, however dead you are. Like us. They don't have to accept what nature gave them anymore.
Have you ever performed a termination?
No. Have you ever sanctioned one?
This isn't human.
It may be half human.
I believe that's what I said.
Your plans? Private. I'd like to help you if I can.
Thanks. I'll manage.
You shouldn't have to face the trauma of another miscarriage. If you let nature take its course, it could take weeks. Morning sickness, paying for nothing. Nature can be very cruel. A DNC, on the other hand, is a very simple procedure.
If I do decide to have a termination, it won't be performed by the police, I can assure you.
It won't be a termination. There is no pregnancy. You've seen for yourself.
You're not my doctor. I don't even know what kind of a doctor you are. If I'm not mistaken, you're investigating me for murder, aren't you? And you do minor surgery between interrogations. I don't think so. Is my lift here yet?
How long has her husband been dead? And you?
6 years.
You said he took one of her daughters. Why was that?
They wanted Angie, but she wouldn't go. They say they only take those who want to go. I don't tell you what they do to make you want to go.
What happened?
P.S.
Well, it did them both.
Didn't bat an eye. Yeah, that's how the story goes. Little girl's 5 years old at the time.
Do you have any children?
Yes.
How many?
Twins.
Was it easy for you?
It wasn't difficult.
Will you have any more?
No.
And you don't mind if I invade your privacy?
Go right ahead.
There's no mistake, I'm sorry. You can see a heartbeat at 5 weeks.
5. I just wanted to be sure.
Why don't you go home? We can talk about what you want to do in the morning.
I want to know if it's better to let it happen by itself. I don't want to reduce my chances.
The risk of infection is tiny. Some people prefer to get it over with.
Can you get me in somewhere?
Tonight?
No problem. Mrs. Wainwright, that's correct. She's booked in at 11:30. No, it's a standard D&C. I just need you to preserve any tissues for transport.
This is ridiculous. You think I'm going to kill someone?
What is it?
Oh, something.
Check it out, Mike.
Marion, no one's lying to you. There's no pregnancy. Whatever you're feeling, there's nothing inside you. Even if we were both lying, there's no way you'd feel anything this early. Just let me take a look at you. I promise I won't do anything.
Don't touch me! Someone. I don't know why they've been... They're trying to force me.
Marion, I never met this woman before today. I've been working for 5 years to help you achieve a pregnancy. Why would I try...
I'm not having a termination!
It's not... Okay, whatever. Go home. No one's trying to bounce you into anything. The hospital can wait till you get a second opinion. That's perfectly fine by me.
I'm afraid it's not as simple as that. She's still in custody. She goes with me.
You're not the police. I deal with the police every day. Who are you?
You're ill.
You know. You know I'm pregnant. Me, will you?
Marion. You must come with me. I'm the only person who can help you.
Wait! Whoa! It wasn't your fault. One of us should have been there. I'll take responsibility for this.
I doubt Pierce is going to be particularly interested. Who let her go?
She won't get far on her own steam.
Exactly.
Wainwright won't try and take her. Not if he wants to keep what she's carrying.
There are worse things than being taken. I want to talk to... I need to talk to Inspector Lee. There's a Detective Inspector Lee. He's at Fenchurch Street. Please hurry.
Jacqueline Seabrook. She's a midwife. Okay. Okay, we'll just pull her files and see if she's got any other addresses. I'll let you know.
What do you think they were going to do when it was born? Take it away from her?
I doubt if it had much use for the breast. All they wanted was a womb.
You think he'd do that to his own wife?
Well, look what he's done already.
It's Marion Wainwright. We met about 6 months ago. You were investigating a hit and run. A colleague of mine, Dominic Keep. There've been some people. They say the police, they've been questioning me and... They've found out I'm pregnant. I am pregnant, but they
Mrs.
said
Wainwright,
I wasn't.
I'm sorry, I can't discuss this. I'd like to, but I'm afraid I have to pass you on. Please hold on.
No, please. I want to tell you what they've been trying. Hello? Don't transfer me.
Mrs. Wainwright, the police don't hang up. I know you're traumatized, and I'm sorry you haven't been given all the facts. I'm here to correct that. Are you there? You are pregnant. It's not your husband. I know how much you wanted his child, and I'm sorry. But you are in danger, and I have to be brutally honest. The samples he left at the clinic have been tampered with. The symptoms you're experiencing are not part of a normal pregnancy. You must have realized that, the pain. The blackouts. It's an experiment, an illegal experiment conducted by friends of your husband. For your own safety, you have to terminate it. If you don't trust me, go to a hospital or an abortion clinic. Go soon. The people who did this to you will be looking for you.
Mrs. Seabrook, I'm investigating an assault on Marion Wainwright. I understand you had an appointment with her next month.
What's happened? Is she all right?
Can we go inside?
You found us all right. I promise we're totally confidential. I haven't told anyone you're here. Can I just ask who recommended us?
I got a list from directory. I couldn't risk going to one of the bigger ones.
Okay. Now, who is it that's trying to force you into this?
Oh, it doesn't matter. I just need some medical advice. You said on the phone I could...
No problem. Just sit down and we'll sort something out for you.
What's a midwife want with a hideaway like this?
A nursery? Acoustic shielding. They must have been expecting a screamer. I wonder where the blood bags are.
If it was in here now, you'd pull the plug. Wouldn't you?
Angie'd kill me. She'd want it for the lab.
You're very big on vitamin D.
I certainly am. Very essential. You need it to absorb calcium.
Yes, I know. I think she might be deficient.
Not if she follows this diet.
You haven't mentioned the best source of vitamin D. Sunlight.
I think she has an allergy.
What kind of tests?
I need to know if there's a way of establishing who the father is before it's born. DNA, blood, I don't know.
Is that why you're considering an abortion?
Look, I'm sorry, I didn't come here for counselling. It's complicated. I can't go to hospital. I just want to know what's possible. Do you have a doctor on call?
I'm a nurse. I know all the procedures. I just want you to appreciate the psychological effects of any medical decision you make. Amazing how people can make pro-life sound like an insult.
That's not how you advertised yourselves. I wanted independent advice.
You want people who know what they're talking about. I've assisted on dozens of abortions. But it was only when I had one myself that I found out what it does to women. It's not a solution. You don't have to believe in God.
But it helps.
As a matter of fact. But I'm not trying to...
Goodbye.
This is the most important decision you'll ever make. Don't make the mistake I did. It ruined my life. Religion doesn't come into it. You can leave here and walk into any number of abortion factories and have a few trauma counselling arguments. Why do you think that is?
Forward. There's been a virus going around at the clinic. We'll send someone to pick you up.
I've got a doctor. I'd rather see him.
I'm sorry, that won't do. And it is notifiable. We'll have to withdraw your license until you've been cleared. I'll let myself out.
Hello? Yes, it is. Mrs. Wainwright. Yes, I do.
Who is this? I've just been interviewed.
I'm so sorry to trouble you. I thought you should know. I think someone should be there who knows her. Who knows what she wants. Before the doctors get hold of her. Hello?
Who else have you contacted?
Just the people who are treating her. The Moorcroft Clinic.
She's still not arrived and they can't raise the ambulance.
Wait for us.
I'm going to check the route between here and the advisory centre.
Come on.
Step away. You're not taking her.
Then she'll die.
She's going to live. Step away.
She doesn't want to live. Not like this. Empty.
You made sure of that. If there was any chance of happiness with another man, you killed it.
I died to give her what she wants. She would have been so happy. You killed that, not me.
Please. My husband.
Thank you.
There's embryonic tissue in this one. She miscarried in the pro-life office.
Thank God. So, why do you think they wanted her?
She'd still be carrying some remains, which I expect they wanted to look at post-mortem.
She couldn't have survived.
Not with that degree of hemorrhaging.
Maybe you wanted to cross her over.
She didn't have anything else they want. She's not a scientist.
So it couldn't be that her husband wanted her back.
Love after death. You're just an old romantic, aren't you? We'll fix that. Can I drive you back?
This, Marion, I'll be gone. I'm sorry. I'm just not as strong as you. Life's got the better of me. This'll be hard for you to understand, I know. But where I'm going, I'll be able to help you more than I can now. And believe me, I'm never going to be far away. I'll always be watching over you. One day you're going to get what you want, I promise. And one day, the three of us will be together. Waiting. This isn't the end.